So today's topic is going to be on high cholesterol on keto. So many people sometimes freak out because their cholesterol is too high. I've done quite a few videos on this, but I wanted to create a video on something very specific that you need to know about. So here's the big point. A good amount of your cholesterol, and by the way, there's two organs in your body that make cholesterol. One is the liver, but also the intestines. So a good majority of your cholesterol is controlled by bile salts. Okay, so bile salts are made by the liver and the intestine. All right, so we've got the liver and the intestine. And excess cholesterol is eliminated through various pathways involving bile. So you need bile to eliminate excess cholesterol. And the regulation of excess cholesterol is dependent on bile. Now, as far as the small intestine goes, there's these little receptors, and they're called bile acid receptors. Another name for bile acid receptor would be an FXR receptor. Not that you need to know that. Now, what these receptors do is they regulate cholesterol by suppressing cholesterol. Now, the liver also influences cholesterol as well, but not as much as the small intestine. The small intestine really regulates HDL, the so-called good cholesterol. Well, it's not good or bad. It's the cholesterol from the cell back to the liver. So look at this right here. We've got HDL goes from the cell back to the liver, and then LDL goes from the liver to the cell. So they're just transportation proteins, as in high-density lipoprotein or low-density lipoprotein. All right, so far so good. Let's go on to the next slide. There's another condition called cholesterolemia. Okay? Now, essential means they don't know what causes it. Very similar to essential high blood pressure. They don't really know what causes it. We know it's usually vitamin D and low potassium. But essential hypercholesterolemia includes familial hypercholesterolemia. And this is that condition which is genetic, okay, which people are concerned about because they don't really think they can do anything about it. But you can do things about it, and I will put a link down below. So that's just one part. There's other causes of this unknown high cholesterol. A high-fat diet. Okay. But if you have high cholesterol, it'd be a very good idea to get some advanced lipid testing to really find out more of what's going on. You're going to find out the type of high LDL that you have is actually the good LDL, but I don't want to get into that right now. I want to kind of stay on track. So we have genetics, high-fat diet because you're doing keto, but also hypothyroidism. That can cause high cholesterol in the blood. Also, kidney damage. And a deficiency in bile. Okay? Now that can be from some obstruction from a kidney stone, or, and that's what I really want to talk about right now. So what causes a deficiency in bile? Because bile is very, very important in breaking down fats to absorb fat-soluble vitamins. It helps lubricate the colon. It helps prevent SIBO in the small intestine. But it also has a very important function in regulating cholesterol. Okay? So what would cause a deficiency in bile? Main thing is liver damage. Okay? As in a fatty liver, an inflamed liver, as in hepatitis, or a liver that's filled with fibrotic tissue, or a liver that has scar tissue, which is called cirrhosis. Okay? So all three of those conditions will cause a deficiency in bile, because anything that decreases the liver function decreases the amount of bile production. But you also have the small intestine. And that would be the next thing I'll mention. If you have intestinal damage, okay? So let's say you had a series of antibiotics that just destroyed your intestine. Or let's say you have celiac or Crohn's or diverticulitis. Any inflammation or damage in your small intestine will decrease the production of bile, and that can spike the cholesterol. Now, because your friendly bacteria, the microbiome, also help to recycle bile, if there's a problem in the microbiome, you're not going to make enough bile. So the good bacteria could be another thing to look at. Or it could be that you had the gallbladder removed. You have no gallbladder. In which case, you're going to have less bile. So all of these are factors that can contribute to high cholesterol. I just wanted to bring up your awareness and another link to high cholesterol that you need to be aware of, because a solution, a very simple solution, would be, if you had liver damage, is just to take some purified bile salts, okay? And that is going to help regulate cholesterol. Now, it also could be that you need to take more good bacteria, okay? So that's another solution right there. Or it could be that you have a slow thyroid. So the point is that in order to fix something, you have to know all the potential causes and then what's the most likely cause. All right, thanks for watching, and tell me what you think of this new format. I'm just trying it out.
Hey, we're back.
With another amazing recipe.
No grains, no sugar, totally keto. There's no suffering in keto.
Absolutely not, Karen.
And it's an immune system builder.
Absolutely. You have to check this out.
I think you should hurry up, watch the recipe, and make it yourself. It's just so easy to be keto.
But is it simple?
It's super simple. We hope you enjoy making it as much as we are enjoying eating it.